Hi, my name's Nick, and I have a Bible verse to show you. He says, I will declare your name to my brothers and sisters. In the assembly, I will sing your praises. This is important to me because it's people coming together to praise the Lord like how we do.
Welcome to Jumanji. I'm just kidding, it's chapel, but I just got, hat hair alert. There, that's much better. Welcome to the third week of our True Story series. We've been having so much fun learning about true stories from the Bible. Sometimes adventurers come across some pretty big challenges. In today's true story, one adventurer and follower of God was in big need of a rescue. And God rescued him from jail, but in an interesting way. Now, what makes rescue stories so interesting and fun to watch? They usually involve something miraculous or amazing, and God's word is full of true stories of God rescuing his people. Today's story is one of those. Today's full story can be found in Acts chapter 12, verses 1 through 17. And you can read it yourself from your own Bible or if you have the Bible app on your phone, but I'm just going to give you an overview right now. This story has to do with Peter, who is the same person that we learned about last week when God told him that he loves and accepts everyone. And after that, Peter went around telling everyone about Jesus, but then something bad happened. The king, Herod, didn't like what he was doing, and he threw him in jail. Now, do you think that Peter would have been discouraged and felt pretty sad when he was thrown in jail? I think so too. Now, you might not have ever been thrown in jail, but you probably have experienced some things that got you pretty discouraged and sad. Maybe someone has treated you badly or got you in trouble when you didn't deserve it. Peter didn't deserve to go to jail, but Peter didn't stay in jail. Something amazing happened. An angel came to Peter and broke his chains off and led him right out of jail. He even walked out right between two of the guards. See, whenever you face hard times or temptation or feel afraid, it can weigh you down, just like the chains on Peter. Do you know what God did to those chains on Peter, though? He broke those chains. He set Peter free. God can give you freedom too. He can help you face whatever is weighing you down. And he can help you overcome anything that you're tempted by or afraid of. God is powerful and he can set you free. And that leads us to the big idea today, which is Jesus gives us freedom. Have you ever seen a really cool video of someone getting rescued? Why do you think we like watching rescue videos so much? Because it's amazing to see people who were stuck in a bad situation get saved and be set free. God set Peter free from jail, and you might not be in jail, but you probably still have some things that are holding you down or hurting you. Some things that might keep us prisoner are our bad choices, or our bad attitudes or behaviors, or maybe even bad things that are happening to us. I'm going to read one more verse from us, and this one is from Matthew chapter 1, verse 21. It's a verse that we normally read during the holiday time because it talks about Jesus' birth, but we're going to read it today too. It says, "She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." In this verse, the angel is telling Mary that they should name their baby Jesus, because the name Jesus means to rescue or save. What did the angel say Jesus would rescue us from? He came to rescue people from sin and the consequences of sin, separation from God. This is the biggest thing that we need God to save us from, that we need God to set us free from. Now I've got an image for you to think of. How many people think it'd be pretty easy to rip a piece of toilet paper? Yeah, it's pretty easy, isn't it? But what if I take this toilet paper and I wrap it around and around and around. Until it's wrapped really hard around my arm. If there's more of it wrapped, do you think it's harder to rip? Let's see. It's ripping a little bit, but it's still wrapped around me though. Did you ever think that paper could be so strong? See, sometimes we get wrapped up in something that seems little at first. But then it builds up and builds up and builds up until it's stronger than we are. And then we feel trapped. The same thing happens with our sins. We can get caught up in something small, but eventually it turns into something big that holds us down and keeps us from God and hurts us. But we can ask for God to forgive us and free us from our sins and problems before they become so big that they just hold us down and become stronger than we can be. Now I better put this back before Miss Megan gets mad at me for using the toilet paper. This story makes me think of another type of chains, paper chains. Even though most of you kids have probably never been in jail, we all know things that hold us down and hold down the people that we love. And so one of the ways that you can remember that is making a paper chain. So what I want you to do is get some paper, cut it into strips like this, and then write something on the strip that you need to be set free from. Or maybe someone you know, something that they need to be set free from. Write it right on the strip of paper and then curl it together. And make a chain link. And then you're gonna write something down on another piece of paper. Something that God can set you free from because he's more powerful. And then you do it like that. And you keep going like this. And then I want you to hang it somewhere in your house. And every time you see it, you can just pause for a minute and pray and thank God that he can set you free from these things. Thank God that these things don't have to weigh you down or hold you down or hurt you anymore because Jesus gives us freedom. Thanks so much. See you next week.
Hi, everyone. It's Elizabeth from Praise Team. I just wanted to say hi. I miss you all so much. I hope you're keeping busy during this time. And I'm going to read a passage from Hebrews 13, verse 5. Don't let money be satisfied with what you have. For God has said, I will never fail you, I will never abandon you. I think this is especially important during this time because although we're really limited to a lot right now, we can still be thankful for what God has already provided for us and that there will be light at the end of the darkness. Anyways, I hope you have a great rest of your day and I really miss you all, and so I hope to see you guys as soon as possible. Bye!